चल रहा. सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट इक्वेशंस ऑफ मोशन ऑफ योर बॉडी मूविंग इन योर स्ट्राइट लाइन. So this is a 9th class topic. So in a motion chapter, we have equations of motion of your body moving in a straight line. So we have equations of motion. They are, first equation of motion V is equals to U plus AB. Second equation of motion S is equals to UT plus half AT square. Third equation of motion V square minus U square is equals to 2AS. And another one is also there, that is SN is equals to U plus A of N minus 1 by 2. So these are equations of motion of your body moving in a straight line, children. So now we are going to derive. So these equations in this class now. So first, what is about equation of motion? First, what is about equation of motion, children? When a body moves in a straight line, with uniform acceleration, then the relation among its initial velocity, so denoted by U, final velocity denoted by V, magnitude of displacement denoted by S, and time taken denoted by A is represented as equations. Those equations are called, equations of motion of a body. So this is the definition for equations of motion of a body, children. So when a body is moving in straight line with uniform acceleration, that is, body is moving on the road, body is not moving in the air, not a moving up, not a moving down, but we are taking a body moving on the ground, on the road, in a straight line with uniform acceleration. So then it has a physical quantities like initial velocity, final velocity, displacement to time taken. So among these physical quantities, the relationship is written in the form of equations. Those equations are called equations of motion. So now you can see, so the equations, they are given by numbers. First equation of motion, V is equals to U plus AT. Second equation of motion, S is equals to UT plus half AT square. And third equation of motion, V square minus U square is equals to 2AS. Children, you can see there the physical quantities of this body moving in uniform, moving in straight line with uniform acceleration. V final velocity, U initial velocity, acceleration, time. So magnitude of displacement or distance, initial velocity, time taken, constant, acceleration, time taken. Final velocity, initial velocity, acceleration, magnitude of displacement. So there are no other physical quantities except mentioned here. Only whatever the physical quantities mentioned here, those are here. That is why the relation among these is written as in the form of equations. Those equations are called equations of motion of a body. Now children, we derive these equations. So derivation of first equation of motion, or v is equals to u plus at. So consider a body is a moving. Consider your body is a moving in a straight line with uniform acceleration. With uniform acceleration. Then it has a physical quantities like initial velocity, final velocity, time taken, displacement. So like that, we know that the formula of acceleration. Acceleration A is equals to rate of change of velocity, that is given by A is equals to V minus U by T. Acceleration, we know that. Acceleration A is equals to V minus U by T. This implies A is written as A by 1, V minus U by T, where V is the final velocity, U is initial velocity, T is the time taken. So now by the cross multiplication, so 1 into V minus U is equals to A into T. This will be multiplied with 1, V minus U is equals to A T. Now changing the place of minus U, that is AT plus U. So V is equals to AT plus U or U plus AT. You can write like this. This is the first equation of motion, children. So you maybe understood this one. So here a body is moving with uniform acceleration in a straight line. Then its initial velocity is U, final velocity V, acceleration A, and time taken T. So now we are going to derive second equation of motion. Second equation of motion. So derivation of second equation of motion, or S is equals to ut plus half at square. Here also description we want to write as we explained in the previous one. So consider a body is moving with uniform acceleration in a straight line. Then its initial velocity is equals to u. Let its final velocity is v. Time taken is t. Distance traveled is s. So here we want to use the formula. We know that average velocity is given by two formula. So we can take average velocity. It is written as VAVZ is equals to S by T. It is equation one. And another one, V average is equals to final velocity plus initial velocity by 2. So these two formula
we can write. So from equation 1 and 2 children, average velocity is given by total displacement by total time taken. V average is equals to S by T. Another one is also their formula, final velocity plus initial velocity by 2. So from equation 1 and 2, what can we write? So we can write S by T is equals to these two from equation 1 and 2 left side are equal, then we can compare the right side ratios. S by T is equals to V plus U by 2 children. So now by the cross multiplication, S is equals to V plus U by 2 into T. This is equation number 3. So we know that first equation of motion, just now we derived V is equals to U plus AT children.
V is equals to U plus AT, first equation of motion.
So now substitute this, consider this is equation number 4. Substitute equation number 4 in 3. So in the place of small v, so this implies S is equals to, we can write V means you can write U plus AT, U plus AT plus U by 2 into T children. Then S is equals to U plus U, 2U plus AT into T by 2 children. S is equals to multiply with T, 2UT plus AT square. Separating the denominator for these two quantities, it can be written as by 2 and by 2. So 2 will be cancelled. Now we get S is equals to S UT plus half AT square. This is the derivation of second equation of motion children.
So you may be understood this one clearly. So here we want to use a two formula mainly. So average velocity is equals to total displacement by total time. Another one is sum of velocities by number of velocities, that is final velocity plus initial velocity by 2. So now comparing these two and substituting first equation of motion in this one, we can get S is equals to UT plus half AT square. So that is the second equation of motion derivation. So now we go to derivation of third equation of motion. So what about third equation of motion now? Third equation of motion, now we are deriving. So derivation of third equation of motion, or V square minus U square is equals to 2AS. Yes. So here also we want to write a description, few lines of description for this answer. So consider a body is a moving with uniform acceleration in a straight line. Let its initial velocity is equals to U, final velocity is equals to V, this magnitude of displacement or distance traveled is S, time taken is T. So just now we use the formula for average velocity. We know that average velocity VAVZ is equals to total displacement by total time 1. And consider this is equation 1. Another formula for average velocity, just now we wrote sum of the velocities by number of velocities, that is final velocity plus initial velocity by 2. Now from equation 1 and 2 children, we can compare these two, because left side quantities are equal, then we can compare right side ratios. So V plus U by 2 is equals to S by T. Now cross multiplication children, so this implies only we are doing cross multiplication, that is 2 into S. V plus U is equals to 2S by T. Consider it is equation 1. We know that from first equation of motion, V is equals to U plus AT. This implies V minus U is equals to AT. Consider this is equation number 2. So now we are multiplying equation 1 and 2. This implies equation 1 and 2, we are multiplying So equation 1, on the left side v plus u, in equation 2, left side v minus u. So in the equation 1, left side v plus u, and in the equation 2, left side v minus u. So we are multiplying the quantities present on the left side of equal sign first, v plus u into v minus u. Now we are multiplying the right side quantities, 2s by t into at. tt will be cancelled. So children, you can see this is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. So we know the formula, a plus b into a minus b, which is equals to a square minus b square. Here a means v and b means u. So with this we can write v square minus u square is equals to 2s into a, 2as. This is third equation of motion, children. So these are three equations of motion. So for a body moving in a straight line along the road or on the ground, so with uniform acceleration. So that's all the derivations of equation. So thank you.